Okay. Test, test. Always have to start with a test. One of these days, I'll figure out how to test before I'm actually going live. Seems it's working. Seems we're good. Let me just take this headset off. Much better. Okay. So, what are we doing today? I found this image that I like, that I thought it would be fun to riff off of this. I'm going to pull this over. Look at this. Look at that. When I look at these, I think there's a lot of potential here to just kind of riff off of this one. This one in particular, right here. I think there's all these different shapes going on. There's this kind of this motif. You can see there's kind of this original structure underneath with this stone that's, you know, started to wear away and just cracked. That's exposing that, but over top of it you would have this maybe some kind of sandstone plaster type thing that's you know, making that a smooth surface. And then you got the tiled roofs. You got different shapes going on here. You know, this is the, all these things are just, they're unique, you know. And then you got this wooden structure that's on top. That's something that I find interesting in particularly in old architecture. You know, we find these things, and all that survives is the main structure. It's got some people up there for scale. You know, the foundations are all that would really survive. And if you think about it, so much more could have been built on top of that. We don't know. You know, this is just my speculative theory, but you look at something like Stonehenge, and, you know, there's the idea of it being like a, you know, casting shadows or like tracking celestial bodies or that sort of thing. That's all good and fine. And there, you know, obviously it does align with some things. But, you know, what if there was more of a structure around it, you know, whether that was a wooden or a tent or something like that. You know, the thing could have looked completely different. So anyway, I find that interesting. So I find in this, you know, this, you get the rough stones here at the bottom, transitions up to this smooth stuff, and then you have these wooden, you know, lighter structures, lighter materials up top. And then these things would have been built over a pretty long period of time, and so they have different features, right? So, like, was this, you can see the stone is different there, was this built at the same time as this? I don't know. I'm going to say, seems to me like this section up front here was probably either redone or built later. Maybe this little tower here was added on later. Just judging by how nice the finish is on everything and how light the material is compared to the rest of it that's really weathered. But the architecture as well. You know, was this an earlier structure here and then started to add onto this side, and we really changed the motif. Like, look at these, you know, these, I'm not an expert on this style of architecture. Someone who studied this could tell you all, you know, what period this probably came from just based on the design. But you can see the shape of these windows and then these crenellations with these little arrow, I think that's what these are for. So you can kind of hide behind this, but you can still shoot out. I'm not seeing that design anywhere else. I'm not seeing any of those designs really anywhere else. The window shape or the crenellation. Right, so then you see kind of these wooden braces here and in here. not seeing that here. You know, that's got a different motif there. So it seems to me that these sections might have been built in different eras, you know, or different time periods. So, okay, that was a long lead up to say, I think there's a lot here to play with, and we don't have to paint this castle, but it can act as inspiration. Looking at the chat, we got Adonis in the chat. Welcome. You're going to paint along with this theme. I'm not sure what castle this is. I believe it's Bran Castle, B-R-A-N. If you want to look that up, get some reference. I don't know if it would be necessarily called a castle, though. To my recollection, there were a fair number of like fortified structures and fortified churches in that area, and so though by today's standards we might call it a castle, at the time I think they were just we'll say a network of fortified structures. Okay, so I'm gonna get myself a decent sketching brush. I'm feeling probably this natural drag and just bring it down in size. And I'm gonna zoom in too because I'm working in a large area. I'll end up using larger brushes and slow things down. Okay, so I'm looking at these little chimney shapes. I think these are super cool. One moment. Excuse me. That sneeze came on fast. All but certain these are chimneys. Okay, so just judging by the scale. Let's extend that a little bit there. Maybe erase. I don't know. I like that line, so. Nah, it's not worth it. Get rid of the whole line. They gotta line up. Okay. Alright, now. There's a couple of them, right? So maybe you'd have, I don't know if you've been in a house that has multiple fireplaces. My brother lived in this house years back that previously was like a coach house or like a, what do you call it? Like a horse coach. Establishment. So anyway, it had, you know, it was kind of broken up into these different areas, and so there was like a fireplace upstairs, a fireplace downstairs, and I mean you could kind of see like if it were more of a business that that had to house multiple parties. You know, you had your people that worked there and you had whoever was coming in on the coach. So anyway, it may be way more common than I think, but that was the first time I was in a house that had like multiple fireplaces upstairs, downstairs, you know, because that was how when the structure was built, that's how they would have heated it, right? So anyway, I'm seeing these multiple chimneys here as probably being, you know, maybe there's a fireplace, you know, way down here for this big one, and then a fireplace on the upper level, you know, on this other one here, and but of course the roof comes out, and we're going to do it this way because we're actually, the castle's big, so we're looking up at it, not down at it. Der. Here we go. One of the other things I think is interesting about these, you know, that you can imply is that there's, you know, you could have like this would be like a stairway with some windows in it, right? So you don't just always go straight across, you know, window, 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 you know what I mean? That would imply that that's either a hallway or a series of rooms or something like that, you know, if they're like evenly spaced and on the same level. But I like this, you know, method of kind of implying that there's more going on inside the structure, you know. So like if we have a tower here and get this going on right here, so you got this window here, and then we do the next window kind of flatter on the side, and then we just kind of follow that, you know, in that spiral pattern. So we figure there'd be here, there may be one here, and then on the back side there, here, and then the next one would be like right here. Okay, so we'll put in our next window here, put in one here. Put the top of our tower right there. And that does a couple things for us, in my opinion. The first thing is that it makes the shape more interesting, makes the structure less of this, you know, simple linear thing. But it also gives your eye something to follow, right? And we can start playing with this if we want to design, if we want to design the image to kind of lead the eye around. So if we wanted the eye to kind of come up here, you know, if we had something perhaps up here, you know, and then we could put in a shape here that, I don't know, let's just say if we're designing this composition, now I've kind of killed it. But if we're trying to get the eye to follow that course, that would be a way to do it. Right now, what I'm seeing is I'm gonna actually undo, go back a little bit, show you what how I'm evaluating what's happening. I'm seeing this. Everything's kind of leading down here. So if we had this like doorway, you know, that might be a way to compose this. Because all these lines lead into it. Looking at the chat, Donna says, "Can you tell me the theme of the painting again, please? I think I missed it." Okay, so this is, I believe, Bran Castle. I'm not gonna do this exactly, but I just want to pull out different elements that I'm seeing in it, particularly how things morph in their different areas. So, like down lower, we have this rough stone where this plaster has been worn away. You see that stone revealed. You've got older parts of the structure. You've got newer parts of the structure. You've got architecture from appears to me to be one time period, and then perhaps they added on later. And you've got architecture from another time period. So there's just a lot going on here, and there's a lot of variety in shapes too, right? Like, so these, I'm almost certain, are chimneys, right? Just based on the size of these people, you wouldn't have somebody up in there, right? So that's got to be chimneys. And then you also got different material too. You got this wood up top, and you got these different shapes. So there's a lot going on here that we can just start playing with. And I'd like to push it and start to kind of stylize it a little bit. So I'm actually moving really slowly on this drawing. So I am going to lower the opacity so that I'm not too stuck on, you know, the lights and darks, you know, bothering me, that I feel like I've got to sort everything out perfectly, and I'm just going to start moving a little more quickly. And I like the we'll stylize it, you know, a little bit here, where we've got these shapes. Having a little bit more character to them. These chimneys. A lot of these shapes, I'm thinking, excuse me, I'll have kind of pinch in towards the bottom. I don't really care for that. I think maybe if we just round it out on the top there. Maybe, I don't know if we want to curve these or not. That would imply a completely different architectural reference point. Okay. This tower here, maybe we'll have a structure popping off of that. I think we need to bring something in, as in leaning in towards it. Counterbalance some of that a little bit. Do we want, you know, if we have this lean out, that it doesn't feel like it's completely falling over. Shadow lower. Let me bring this down and then like bring a little roof out like this. I'll do windows in here. Let's see what else we got. This, instead of just this square roof motif, we could try something else here. I'm seeing a couple different shapes there. So some are like this, right? Like what we just did, square. And then some actually curve up just a little bit on the inside, and then they come to a kind of a cone, right? Like that. And then it looks like it has perhaps some kind of decorative thing on top, like a, you know, gargoyle-y type thing. What else have we got here? One of these other structures, it does the same thing, but then it flares out a little bit more at the bottom. And then there's some rounded forms, and some of those are, they're rounded, but then they're like cut off, Right, so it'd be like, looks like we've had one that kind of over here, it like curves around and then it like just cuts straight over there. You know, you could probably put another cut in there and then still have the curvature here. See if we can just do this on that backside, like have something completely in shadow there. Might be cool too to see like, some walkways and stuff. So, you know, we're throwing in these shapes, but like, if here we have, okay, we got the, maybe the crenellation type things, but we could throw in like a metal railing. Think even just like little drainage bits. That'd be fun to play with later, you know, just weathering on those. One of the things that I think is interesting with, you know, doing castles is trying to figure out the distribution of detail. In order to get it to feel like this massive, strong structure. Like you can add in more detail and the detail will help give you some scale, right? If you're looking at the size of the windows and all that sort of thing. But if you get too detailed with it, then just kind of the massive stone, you know, just the feeling of it being these imposing walls and everything, that can get lost a little bit. Okay. That is tangent with that, and that drives me crazy. Drives me crazy. You're welcome. Okay, don't like this. I'm gonna adjust that. And I think I'm just going to extend this right out. You know, it's like I'm almost allowing it to be an interesting shape, interesting form, you know, but almost, not quite there. Do I want this to be round? I mean, it is implied. You know, just in this shape right here. If you make a mess, clean it up. What we're doing right now. Another thing is that I keep seeing these faces, and anytime you look at a structure, like even on this reference over here, you've got like window, arch, little window down here. And then, I mean, tell me that's not a face. Once you see it, you can't unsee it. And then you try to do stuff to it, and it's like, it just gets emotional, you know? Sad castle. You know what I mean? Okay. This structure, I think it needs interior pieces here. Let's go with that wooden motif again. Yeah. This back here is kind of farther in the background. So I'm going to start making these windows a little bit smaller back there. And again, if we reference these same shapes, like these guys up here, we just make them smaller. Then we got ourselves some diminishing the size. Fake some perspective that way. Is it faking though? Is it really faking if you've really done it? If you perceive perspective, is that not what it is? It's all perceptual anyway. We couldn't not be philosophical, you know? It had to happen. It had to come out. Okay, I am kind of frustratingly laboring over this. It's driving me nuts. Maybe it's the caffeine talking, you know? Too much caffeine late at night. You get the unrealistic expectations. Ooh, bother. Maybe we'll put some gargoyles around there. Have something. Maybe. Ooh, might be fun to have like a shape that comes out of here and then through the roof. Busting through the roof. And then. Tangent again. Some of these shapes, I just wanna push them over. You go that way, and you over here. You go that way, and the whole thing can just move down. What do we got here? We got this roof section here. Get another little chimney shape. Just say there's another one of these things. It'll have to be lower. Maybe we'll do one over here. What do we got? Let me get rid of these example ones here. And then down here. I think it's interesting once you get down. Well, I mean, I think it's all interesting. But once you get down near the bottom here, then you've got these like. Just these little like walls and like walkways and stuff that really define a lot of the shapes. That's fun. It's like a sad, that sad face is getting even more sad. Maybe we'll put like a. Oh boy. I wonder how many sad faces we can put into this. You know? Right. Maybe we can do a little something right here. Oh boy. So that's a sad face right there. And then we'll do a. Level that out a little more there. Do a little staircase here. have one. I don't know. I think we need one now. And the reference we get, kind of a door that's obscured and like a walkway that goes up to it. I don't know, I think we should consider how we're lead the eye around, you know. So if we maybe whoops, a daisy. We have a wall right here. Maybe cast a shadow there. That would be that's pretty low light. But maybe we'll I don't know. How we wanna handle this. I gotta have the shadow on this side. It comes up and around. Statuettes on there or something. Give it like a. Give these cues for even spacing. This man lost his mind. Put that in shadow right there. Extend that just a little bit further. Probably can't see any of that in the video. Zooming in. Basically just thickened all that up so that it appears to, you know, be the shadow here. Of course, we never really did establish any real shadow shapes. Or real, you know, direction of the light. There's a rough sense of it, I think. But I don't want to see if we can maybe get this, you know, those shapes to integrate right there. Excusez-moi. Then here, let's see. We got this. I want this to be kind of this massive structure here, but then a smaller maybe doorway type thing right here, so we can kind of, you know, put this on a human scale. Finish this roof out right there. And that is the other chimney on the back side of this. So I'm going to bring that right down, because this roof, I'm having it come down to like there, right? Unless we did like some kind of an overhang here, but no sense in that. I don't think they'd build it unless there was a good reason. Psh, who am I kidding? I've been in enough old houses. A lot of reasons that seemed reasonable at the time. And then proved to be otherwise. This one I'm going to have up and then shift it over and have it disappear there. Have that one go down. I don't know. I don't like those shadow shapes. Too linear. Lame sauce. Okay. This I've got kind of intersecting here. Maybe I need to bring this over more. I think I do. Okay. That doorway that we were playing with here never really did pan out. So let's get that figured out. We'll do a kind of junction point right there. And then the shadow from roof. And this, I'm just seeing if I block this in, if it becomes more readable or not. I think not. Maybe this, do this as one of those wooden structure areas. Think these windows could all be smaller. That could probably help us out. This line out there. I'm really just letting these shadow shapes do a lot of the work here. So we start to erase some of the line work. I can hardly even call it line work. It's just like throwing little dots here and there and scribbling. All right, one thing to consider with this is I've got this roof up here. And this I'm showing is like much closer. So I think I need to have this cast more of a shadow. Perfectly on there, but bring that in. I don't know. We'll see what this looks like. Looks terrible, Eric. Well, we saw. Okay, do that. To bring in some of these shadow shapes to describe the form. One thing that I was planning to do from the onset was kind of just throw some trees down in here to have this thing kind of just growing out of more of a pattern of trees, I guess I'd say, you know, so something like this. But I was kind of saving that for later, just because what I found interesting was the shapes of the structure, right? Let's follow that line up, come right here and over. This sad house. Let me increase the shadow on that. Come on. That side. Maybe just the top. I don't know. Okay, what's going on here? Okay, we got these shapes back here, which may end up going into shadow. And then this right here, I think we need to have this kind of, I'm gonna do a little switch here, right? So we got a shadow right here, right? And then we want to show the object that's casting the shadow. So we kind of reverse that edge there. You don't want to carry this shape. If we carried that shape through, then we kill the illusion. They kind of have to switch places. And then I'm going to sharpen up those edges a little bit here. I thought that's what I was going to do. I don't know about those shapes. I might just get rid of that altogether. And then if we just bring in like a tree or something back here. We just need to delineate that one edge there. Do the same thing here. We gotta give that a sharp edge there, so that's the edge of the structure. I don't know if we want to push all this into shadow or not. I mean, this may not even be the stage to be doing that. But as it relates to the rest of the scene, you know, we're doing that elsewhere. So we will need to get a consistent light established. Excuse me. Alright, I'm going to throw some stuff behind all this. Just to like layer in some local values. Shift a little bit. It comes down. It's probably too saturated. And I might go a little more yellow. And then I'm gonna go similar, darker. A couple areas up top here. Kind of wanted these windows to be like weeping a little bit, you know what I mean? Get that wear and tear over the ages. Little erosion. Let me swap that color out so I can kind of just come in and out with it. Okay, do a new layer, bring in that orange roof. Shoo-wee, fella, look at that. Go a little bit more towards... actually, kind of like what I started with. Yeah, whatever, we'll go with that. It's interesting, now that I'm looking at this, the way that I set up the height of these roofs, this is all like tangent here, so I might have to mess with that a little bit. get them all. We need to do some down here. And again, with the diminution, those things in the background, we want to make those thinner. Excuse me. Oh boy. Boy. Maybe we cut these back a little bit here. These guys can go. Lower. In fact, probably that whole thing could just go lower. So that it doesn't interfere with this roof right here. It should line up with that one. But then we're tangent with this. So let's see. Maybe we'll cut this out to here. And then we'll bring in this one right across. Something like that. Cut these ones down again. In fact, maybe we'll take that. Just cut right through there. Definitely looks like a face. It's fun. I'll do another one here.
Oh boy.
Nah, we don't need those. It's a fun thought, but negative. Okay. Suppose we could bring in the green here. And that does not need to be particularly saturated. Something's slowing us down. Windows decided to update all of a sudden, maybe. That's a joke. I'm not actually going to let it do that. But I wouldn't put it past it. Okay, now the trees themselves, you know, now that they have become a graphic element, right? So we can't ignore that. I mean, we could, but it would be fatal, potentially. All right, so I'm gonna pin that layer. Bring in some more that's all on the roof layer. Whoops. Well, that explains a lot. I guess while we're there, may as well play with this a little bit. Throw a little texture on there. Background, lighten that up. Duplicate this and maybe do a. Trying to figure out how I want to. I want to use this to bring in more contrast, but I don't want it to go to white like that. I do kind of like that linear burn. Color burn, lower the fill. And then I'm gonna do let's do linear. I'm gonna ignore anything below it that's, you know, in that range there. And I'm going to shift the colors on this. There we go. That's our drawing layer. We'll set that to multiply. Put in a mask here. Mask out a bunch of this tree. I don't want those to be that harsh. And these background elements too. Let the background be the background. Go back to the background, please. In here, which one is it? This, no, this one. This is kind of interesting. These tones down here. So I'm going to start erasing these away a little bit. I'll try to do it in a directional way, so it has that kind of linear feel to it. What is this, linear burn? I might use this. I might just bring in just a little bit of that in the background. So let's see the difference between that. Yeah, we'll leave that. We'll bring in some be a little bit brighter there. Just some background stuff, as they say. Is that what they say? Yeah, I don't like that. I want to bring in, I think just a soft transition, you know. Whoops, I'm still on the smudge brush. I need to switch over to an actual brush. Brushity brush. Let's do... yeah, we'll do the nasty square. No, let's do the texture brush. That's I think gonna give me the results I want. And this I'm gonna do either darker color. Oh, actually a lighter color looks kinda nice there. I was thinking multiply. I'm gonna do darker color, and we'll just finish this out to the theory that I was playing with here. So that would be, I want to transition these, you know, shapes from a shadow color to a lighter color. But why, though, you ask? I don't know. Couldn't tell you. Just want to do it. I mean, the real story is the contrast, counter change. You know, it just gives this opportunity to play with the shapes a bit. It is, however, making things look much more cartoony. Let's bring in some light. We're probably not, excuse me, I'm not going to need that much of it, actually. Just judging by the shapes here. We'll be bringing it in and then pushing it back. But what I'm seeing is two rounded forms, this one and this one, so I want to gently round those forms there, and then bring in the bounce light, you know, on the far side. And then other than that, I think we could just kind of have, you know, areas that are completely occluded, and then areas that have full light. Bring in some bounce light, maybe. In this background here, do we want to push that back? I mean, I don't really want to. We can show it as a enclosed form, you know, so maybe there's like a courtyard in the middle there. But I don't think we benefit that much from doing that. Let's do overlay. Bring in some of that bounce light off the ground, off the roof. Pretty aggressive there. So I'm gonna lower the contrast on it. Don't like that, so I'm gonna invert that and do it bright here. Maybe bright. There's really nothing, you know, nothing's really bouncing off of that. Maybe we'll do it there. A little bit of bounce light there. You know, in the shadows. Blue light over here on that shadow side. Background bothers me. I think it just needs to be like really simplified. But now I'm gonna just paint in some value here. Yeah, from here, I think a degree of this is just going to be flattening out some of these values, clearing out some of the line. Oh, that's what that is. That's actually a part of our drawing up there. Whoops. Bring that shadow shape in there. Let's see, what do we want from that? Maybe we'll make this. Okay. Just deciding what to do here. I think I don't really care for this that orange there. I'm ending up putting on the roof here, so I'm gonna kind of replace this with like a very gray, like a salmon gray almost. Salmon gray. Who comes up with these colors? Is this thing? I don't even know. It's like you invent a shape and you go, why'd I do that? That was a mistake. This shape never should have been. Okay. Still though, what are we doing? Should make this like a wooden platform or something? So I want to differentiate between this like Moldy. Backsplash from the rain type of green. Gotta differentiate between that and the tree green, right? Well, I do like that that kind of lime looking green there. It's nice. It's nice. Excuse me. What am I even doing here? This is all just cleanup type stuff, you know? Some more bounce light in there. That light down, maybe a crisp shadow shape there, and then a crisp light edge there. That edge. here. Bring those up. Value. Still gotta have some little shadows back there somewhere. I actually kind of like how that roof dissolves into nothing. I like it. Might have to do that again, do that down here. Don't get too excited. All right. Nah. See, I don't like that. Don't like these shadow or these window shapes here. So we're going to redo those. Just thinking this could just be like a door, you know, you think. Put all that effort in to build these stone walls. Could put a hinged door in the entryway, you know. Do a new layer and just get a little more indiscriminate with these cuts and changes here. I just feel like it's slowed down way too much. I don't like that. So I'm gonna try to get this moving more quickly. Yeah, that could even be, I think, even sharper. So crazy as it may sound, this is one of my favorite parts of the process, where you've laid something in, excuse me, and at some point you just decide that you don't think it's working, and you're willing to mess everything up to figure it out. And there's a whole lot more that I could and probably should do here. Like the liquify tool. Start chopping up assets, moving them around. You know, but I think this is a stage where I start to feel like free, you know, free to make whatever kind of change I think it needs.
at that shadow incorporated there. We'll bring these shapes up over top of it. Bring that back down in value a little bit, I think. All right, let's use, because we use the natural drag. And bring in some of these Actually, on this side, I'm going to see fewer of these shadow shapes, I think. Okay. A couple things I think we could do here. Obviously, you do the curves, overlay, all that stuff. I want to keep things generally in the midtones, with the exception of maybe the shadows. That way we can play with that. Saturation. Kind of searching for this daylight, doing a warmer shadows, cooler light color, but now we're playing with the midtones to kind of just to feel out the transition from one to the other. I think we'll do another version of it here. It'll just be either luminosity or one of these darkened ones here. I want to see if we can isolate this to just like certain areas. Okay, I'll go somewhere in there. Now, I'm going to grab all this, make it its own layer. We'll use the liquify, and then we'll play with a few more color ideas. We'll do a new solid color, just to have a background. Let's play with a few things here. See if we push some of this back. That's the wrong one here. Okay, now we can adjust this color back here. Go with our, well, let's duplicate this first. We'll go with our liquify. Excuse me. I do want these trees to be basically straight up and down, you know, just these really clean verticals, so that our anything dynamic in the castle feels even more so by contrast. Okay. Shrink those windows down a little bit. Yeah, I don't like that. I was aiming to have that have a little curvature there to be a little more dynamic. But I don't know about that. I feel like if I do that, I need to adjust that shadow so that it actually feels, you know, dynamic in 3D space and not just not just on that one layer. Yeah, I don't like that. Let's see, there's a reconstruct. Let's reconstruct all that. And then let's push it the other way. Now, these all line up, you know? You notice that? I don't like that. Makes me unhappy. Now, I'd be okay with them kind of referencing each other. I know I've used that term quite a bit in the past, but this one's in front, this one's behind, and so the height of that should not match. That should be higher, that should be lower. Right? Now this edge here is not rounded out, so that's got to be a different shape. Like that. And I think in general, might like that to be smaller. So I'm just gonna push it all up, push this guy together. Don't like the shape though. Kind of drive me nuts. I keep saying that. All right, let's see. These background guys, maybe make them a little smaller. Push that. Then this shape here. This shape, this bothers me. All of this. Not very nice. That's better. Maybe just push all this over just a skosh too. Okay, been fiddling with that way too much. Now we'll see what we need to do here. Let's go with our overlay. All right, let me zoom back in. So we're just kind of doing a little bit of warm, cool transitions here. It's cool in the foreground rather than the background. I don't know. Or we just burn that edge. So that it comes forward. We could probably do some just manual painting here. You know, push some things forward and back. Forward and back, he says. There and back again. Oh, the bum, bum, bum. Oh, that's right. We had this, like, chimney thing there. That was supposed to follow right on through. Don't like it. Okay. I feel like these need to be broken up so that they, well, I don't know. I don't know. Yeah, let's get a little bit of this lighter color in here. There's some fun squiggles in here. Actually, that kind of would be cool. Just to have these, you know, chimneys. Doing something. And then we'll go to our liquefy. I want to keep these somewhat simple, but I also kind of want to connect them. You know, so that the smoke in the background, regardless, like if it's on the same kind of distance layer, I want it to interact in a very similar way, because it would be kind of pushed around by wind or something like that, you know. But then at the same time, I want these to be pretty clean. Shapes. Okay. And we can decide what we want to do. I'll just do a color overlay, I think. We'll just do normal. Push that up to 100, and then we'll just play. See if we want it bright, we want it dark. Bleh. I think we'll just go somewhere in here. And then see, underneath all this, and we're pushing values around a little bit with this overlay. Somewhere there, and then we'll go, I'm just going to do a hue saturation. So instead of doing a color balance, I'm going to start grabbing things by their color zone. And usually what I do is I just pump that up all the way to 100 so that I can see exactly what area I'm working with. And then we can start to adjust this. Get our reds in here. Let's really dial this in so that we're just dealing with, as much as possible, just dealing with the roofs. Okay, we'll grab our yellows. Same thing. Let's isolate out the greens. We'll do the greens separately. And let's see if we can keep this separate from the roof. Let me zoom out here. I can see that we're dealing with this. You know, I want to get those trees out of the area of effect. I think we're also dealing with the transition on this color here. And let's see if we can grab that and get that dialed in. So we'll go with greens. This could, you know, potentially this would be our trees, right? But there's a couple of greens we have to get. We have to address. Might actually be more gray in those areas. And then let's see if we can get that lime green. We'll have to pick a different color. So we might do, because we already used yellow, red, green, and blue. So we can go with, we'll just use magentas. And you can just change it to whatever zone you want. And it'll change the name of it. So we want it's going to be tricky to do with this, but we'll give it a go. Actually, I like that, just kind of like that. Alright, so you can see how we really changed the colors there. Using a hue saturation and being selective about what we wanted, like in what zones. Now there's a couple things we could do. You know, we could mask this off to areas that we want it. So if we want that jump between warm and cool, you know, like if we just gonna start cutting this in here. And we'll see which areas we like it and which we don't. So maybe we want it. Actually, I do kind of like it being bluer up there. Maybe we want it warmer towards the bottom, you know. So we'll come in and erase it as it comes towards the floor. What if we invert it? And I really liked the darkening up this green in here. So I'm gonna bring that back if I can. I think that the shadow colors are too dark. If I wanted that more, cartoony effect, we could play with that. But I'm going to do a couple things here. I'm going to go with color balance, just see if we can push things a little bit more. Actually bringing those shadows in really a separate shapes there when we do this, because it darkens them so much. Alright, and we could do a new layer that is lighter color. I'm going to grab this shadow, I'm going to bump it up, and we're just going to play a little bit here. I'm going to see if I can bump up that shadow color. And where we really want to end up with that, I'm totally sure. I want to go more. There we go. Go a little more saturated with that. Darker with that. All right, I think we're kind of getting to the point where I ought to pause and assess whether this is really doing what I think it's doing. Let me just get a little bit more in here. That might be a little too much. Pushing all of those very darks back. There might be a few places where we still want them though. So let's have a look-see. Leave that, give it just a little bit. Somewhere in there. We'll probably just bring in a few of these goys right here. Let's see, let me zoom out first. do a different brush here. Just to shift this composition around. That curve might be a little bit much. I don't, you know, I wanted to introduce something there, but this is, that's too much. Even this here, maybe if we just have it, you know, like this, you know, we're up on the mountain here, right? So these trees are breaking through the fog, right? Let's see. They reintroduce these trees here. Don't like that shadow, you know, that dark shadow shape there. That's not working for me. All kinds of things that could be said. Sorry if I scared you. No one's listening. Because I stopped talking a while ago. Let's see. It's not too different from its from the neighbor. You know, I'm going to fade that. down, I think. Well, I might invert that. Alright, looking at the chat. Would you do a traditional artwork stream, not digital art? Just curious. Yeah, I would. If I could get the all the technical stuff worked out. I tried doing that a while ago. I mean, years and years ago. I got a camera and I got it set up with some software. You know, so it was a nicer camera. There were some hang-ups with it, but I'm sure there's a solution out there that's probably not too difficult. You know, just some kind of webcam solution or something. I should make that happen. This, of course, is easier. It's just a one-to-one. Excuse me. You know what I think I need to do here? Let me take this. And we'll go... over, have that cast a shadow. I think we'll leave our darks where they are, but we want to bring everything else down. That is getting hideous, I think is the word that I want to use. I think I just need to sharpen this up. Merge all those layers. Go to the erase tool. Smudge brush again, smooth out some of these areas. So obviously this is going to be tricky here, but I do think that the mixture, you know, the decision on whether to use a soft edge or a hard edge is what's going to make this work. Somewhere in there, and then I think we'll clean up some of these areas here. I want some of this harsh texture here, but I want to control it a bit. Okay. I could keep trying to figure this out, but I'm gonna stop here on this one. So a traditional medium stream, that would be, I think that would be cool to do. It would have its own challenges. I would say just right off the bat that I have not done a ton of traditional work, though I am doing a traditional project right now. It's been a while since, you know, that has not been my regular thing for a bit. So I think that would be kind of cool to get back into it, you know, and of course with the whole theme of the stream, just allowing for exploration and so forth. I think that would be fun. Just had the thought here that if I bring some of this blue in, as in like make a shadow here so that some of the cloud is in shadow, that might improve our perception of it. Just simplify that shadow. That. Okay. And then let's just go like 70% with it, something like that. Still, I'm not quite sold on this value in here. Which one is that? Somewhere in there. Looking at the chat, liking the colors, hadn't thought about the equipment part to that. Do you do in-person instruction if you advertise that here? I don't. I haven't done that. I have been debating how I might put together some kind of course type thing. Actually, I meant to say tonight, but I never really got around to it, that I'm revamping my website. I'm going to do a relaunch here shortly, and that was one of the things that I thought would be worth exploring and seeing, you know, if anyone's interested in that, some kind of a course type thing integrated onto the site. I know actually Facebook has it. As much as I dislike Facebook, it has a system for like a course module. You build out the modules, and then you can have people join in, and it would just act like a Facebook group, I guess. But I'm thinking something kind of along those lines. Really, I need to build out the content, but I wanted to put the feelers out to see if anyone would be interested in that, because, you know, this is good. I mean, I think there actually is something really valuable to just watching someone work. And then being able to ask questions or whatever. But this is never going to be like a class or a course or like just teach concepts, you know? And so I'm wondering if that would be, it would be worthwhile to have a place for that. I know there's plenty of other stuff out there, and I would happily recommend them, you know, Schoolism and Control Paint and Watts Atelier, but they're all they all kind of have their own way of doing it, and that's really what I would be wanting to add, is the way that I think would be an effective way to teach. Okay, anyway, all that to say, I haven't built it, but I know I've been talking about it for a little bit. I don't really do that in person. If someone was interested, you could reach out, and that might be something we could figure something out. It is something down the road that I'd like to do. You know, I'd like to have at the least
I want to do a sketch group. We had one in the past, and I'd like to revitalize that. And I'd love to have a painting group that just gets together and paints. Ideally, like once a week, maybe more realistically every other week. But I just think the vast majority of the journey is just doing it, and then having an accountability group, like not just accountability, but like peers, basically, you know, and friends to do it with, makes all that stuff easier. So, yeah, something to think about.
Chat, George P. Castle looks dope. Thank you. Let me just pull up here's the reference that we were playing with. And like I said, you know, we were trying to pull out different elements and different ideas from it and then throw that in here. Some of those things that I mentioned at the beginning of the stream, I never really went with, you know, like the really rough stones and stuff in the worn out areas. Like we never really did build on any too much texture there. Well, I mean, we built a little bit, but didn't get into it too much. But yeah, the big idea was just to take it, push it to some extremes, and take some of the motifs and see if we could just kind of reinvent the castle or the layout, and just borrow some of those things, which is, you know, a lot of what concept art is. You know, grabbing ideas and then pushing them, matching them up with other things. So. All right, I think this is it for tonight. There's always something, you know, like I keep looking at these things, that every painting, it's like you look at it and think, oh, I could adjust that, I could fix that, you know, whatever, but it's always a balancing act. And you're pushing back and forth. So, you know, what I'm seeing is a couple things. So one is, you know, we softened all this up by bringing in this cloud thing. But I really want to get some sharp edges here. You know, like I think I would either come back in to the mask and mask some of this out, or do a smudge brush with a really hard... what's the term here? It is strength. You have that strength like really high, and then do sample all layers and then just like push this around. So that way I'm grabbing the color and kind of stamping that color rather than revealing, you know, like having a layer where the opacity is raised or lowered, because then you get that kind of murky look. And then the other bit, I think, is, you know, I might just be looking at this more graphically, you know, cutting out more shapes, defining that ground plane and defining these different parts. I don't know, could add some birds, and really makes sense to have something that this is about, you know, like, I don't know, a little procession of people coming in here, but alas, it is 12:30, so I'm gonna wrap it up. Manny in the chat says, pretty cool, could use a dragon though. Just kidding, good stuff, my friend. Could use a dragon. Well, we could throw Steve in here. Where's Steve? Hold. How much of the canvas did I use? Did I use the whole thing? Okay, that's surprising that this came in that large, because that's like a web version of it. Yeah, so this could be like the background of Steve's Demise. Be like up here. Maybe they're up on a, what do you? They're up on a platform up here. Ourselves a story. Let's see, how do we get this? Just gotta lean all this in. And we need like a, here, let's get these guys looking more like they're in perspective. Why'd you do this to me, Manny? Why? It needs a hug. I think that's what it needs. A friend? I don't know. Right. It needs a tree. That's it. That's all. Then we can call it done. Let's see. We want scraggly. Well, we could do Manny's palm tree. Probably not the right environment for it. Let's do this scraggly one. We just need enough to imply that there's a good reason for this shadow here. Oh, it's upside down. Oh boy. This this brush was not meant to be this big. How about we do one? To a different brush. This the light, the rough tree. This might be better. No, that's the tree line. Let's do this one. Come on, Photoshop. Don't let me down. Yeah, no. Uh,
Man, he says he just swoops in and derails the whole thing. Typical. Yes, it is typical. But I think I'm an easy target. I have learned. I think we need to erase some of this here. Let's see. Yeah, gotta have those scragglies. Gotta have them. Even though it's like. Barely a part of the painting. Okay. Good idea, Manny. Good idea. We'll go with, let's see. We'll group all this together. Option A. Just a happy castle doing what happy castles do. And then option B. Given some context for this whole interaction here. Sure, it could use more. Don't tempt me. I'm not going to do it. We have to be done. All right. So, we're going to call it there. I like both versions. I actually really like this. It's so tempting to, like, you know, start fixing all those branches and stuff, you know, that are just implied. But, it's time to go to bed. It's time to be done. So, all right. Thank you for joining in tonight. And hopefully you guys had your own projects going on. Yeah, that's funny in the chat. Poor Knight, he not only has to look at his severed leg, but he also has to get home. Yeah. Well, he could call for help. I guess he's close enough that someone might see him smoldering up there, you know. But they're all cozy in the castle. See, they got the fires lit. That guy, Jeff's got to take care of. Steve's causing trouble again. Okay. I gotta stop. All right. I think I was saying that. Really, I hope you guys have your own projects going. If nothing else, just a little sketchbook or something, you know. I was going through my sketches today, and I realized that I, for a while now, have moved almost solely to the pocket sketchbook. And I'd like to get back into doing large drawings and using the Copic markers and stuff more. That's just kind of a side note, but I was going through my sketches to update the site. I'm going to put a sketchbook section up there. I was just digging through everything, and I thought, man, I'd really like to get back to it, you know, doing the Inktobers and that sort of thing. I love the little pencil sketches in the pocket sketchbook. I think it's great for like jotting down ideas and for just getting the gesture of something, you know, like at that size, you're not really trying to get these, you're not really thinking about rendering so much. You're just thinking about whether or not the shapes are cool and whether or not the idea is interesting, which I think are the most important things anyway. But there really is something special about finishing a drawing, you know, taking it to completion once you've got that underlying structure. That's something I'm interested in. It's interesting that you guys asked, Nate, that you asked about doing a traditional stream. Push me on that one again. Ask me about it again, because that's something I want to do, and I know myself, I'm going to need more prodding. So we'll start with this. We'll update the website. We'll get that sketch page up there. I think you guys will enjoy that. Check that out. Every time I look at my past work, it always makes me just want to make more, you know, and make more time to make more. And, I want to be careful that I'm not, you know, I don't think I'm going to burn myself out. At least not at this stage. I've definitely been in that place before where you're just trying to produce too much too often. But I think I am ready at this point to, you know, pick up another session or another, I wouldn't say pick up a new medium, but pick up an old one and add it into the repertoire. Okay, no promises as usual, but that's something that sounds cool to me. You know, it sounds like fun. So, all right, I'm gonna sign out here. That was a long farewell and outro, but I really appreciate everyone joining in tonight. And it was kind of a quiet stream, I appreciate seeing everybody hop in and leave comments in the chat It encourages me, so I appreciate that. All right. Have a good night, everyone.